Hello, my name is Yash, and I'm a product manager on the Azure Blob Storage team. Today, I'll share more about SFTP support for Azure Blob Storage, a new feature that expands Blob Storage's multi-protocol access capabilities and enables you to accelerate your migration from on-premises to Azure. We'll start with an overview of SFTP, then walk through different customer scenarios where we see adoption, and finally, wrap it up with a demo. Let's dive right in. What is SFTP and why should you use it? In our customer conversations, we noticed that file transfers are ubiquitous. Whether you look at retail, healthcare, research, finance, or many other industries and domains, across the board, there are scenarios that require data transfer on a regular basis, whether it's amongst teams within the same company, or partners, vendors, and nodes in the network. Amongst file transfer software, SSH file transfer protocol, also commonly known as SFTP, is one of the most popular ways to transfer files because of its simplicity and security. It's a battle-tested protocol that has been used to move data securely for decades. Many SFTP workloads are still hosted on-premises because object storage platforms don't traditionally support SFTP access. Some SFTP workloads that migrate to the cloud by leveraging VM-based SFTP servers quickly run into maintenance issues. This is because in order to create a robust solution using VM-based SFTP servers, you need to worry about availability, scalability, patching, updating, and so much more. So we've noticed that enterprises want to move their SFTP workloads to the cloud, but are looking for a way to do so without refactoring their applications or having to deal with ongoing maintenance. To address this pain point, we are introducing SFTP support for Azure Blob Storage. Previously, you would have had to maintain separate storage solutions for object storage, file storage, and analytic storage. Azure Blob Storage offers multi-protocol access and eliminates data silos, enabling you to create a unified data lake platform where data can be accessed via SFTP, Blob REST APIs, Azure Data Lake Storage Gen 2 APIs, and can also be mounted via NFS. For example, a healthcare company can ingest data into Blob Storage with AZ Copy, which leverages the Blob REST APIs. Then it can use NFS for training simulation or run analytics jobs on Databricks that use the ADLS Gen 2 APIs. Finally, the company can share processed data with other collaborating researchers via SFTP in a secure and compliant manner. This scenario highlights how you can write with one protocol and read with another with no rewrites necessary. SFTP support is built on top of the Azure Blob Storage Foundation and leverages the hierarchical namespace, which means that you get the rich set of blob capabilities right out of the box for your SFTP workloads. And setting up SFTP is simple. With just a single click, you can now provision an SFTP endpoint for your storage account. Via this endpoint, you get SFTP access to a file system that supports file and folder hierarchy and atomic operations like renames. We are also introducing local users, a lightweight blob storage identity designed for SFTP. And you don't have to deal with provisioning VMs, patching, updating, or scaling. Azure provides highly scalable, fully managed SFTP service and takes care of all the underlying infrastructure so you don't have to worry about maintenance and can focus on unlocking value for your customers. All data is stored as blobs and billed at the same rate as blob storage capacity per GB per month. This pay-as-you-go pricing gives you a very low TCO, and based on your workloads, you can move your data between different tiers such as premium, hot, cool, or archive to optimize costs further and manage your data's lifecycle. In addition to that, you also get the blob storage scale for your SFTP accounts, meaning You can store many petabytes and support workloads that require high bandwidth and high throughput. The rich blob feature set is compatible with SFTP, so you can configure change notifications for data uploaded or downloaded via SFTP, choose from multiple redundancy types based on your disaster recovery scenarios, configure lifecycle management rules, use customer managed keys for encryption, and use data protection features like soft delete and immutable storage. Our customers have been very excited about the adoption of SFTP support and its tight integration with other blob storage features. In public preview, we saw tremendous adoption across a wide range of scenarios. Customers are using SFTP to orchestrate complex data workflows that are triggered based on certain conditions. For example, a user uploads data using SFTP onto Azure Blob Storage. Using Event Grid, this upload triggers an Azure Data Factory job to copy the data to another folder and initiate a webhook to Slack to alert the user that the data landed successfully. We see enterprises in different industries testing and eagerly awaiting to use SFTP. Retail companies with multiple storefronts collect data from their franchisees using SFTP into Blob Storage to get insights via a unified data lake. Then they run analytics workloads using Azure Data Lake Storage Gen 2 APIs without having to copy this data elsewhere. This unlocks insights from data that would otherwise still be on premises because it's challenging and expensive to ingest it into the data lake. Many telecom companies with distributed data collection nodes also have similar scenarios for SFTP. Another use case is financial institutions. They regularly transfer files to and from business partners. These transfers need to be encrypted and secure because different partners and vendors use different application software. Often, SFTP is the common denominator. Leveraging SFTP, banks and financial institutions can do file transfers using a common system while also remaining compliant and secure. Finally, let's take a look at healthcare. Researchers within healthcare collaborate with researchers at other companies, NGOs, and colleges. They need to share datasets regularly and securely. SFTP enables these distributed teams to collaborate by making data sharing simple, effective, and secure. Now, let's check out SFTP in action.
We'll start with Azure Portal and create a storage account with SFTP enabled. You'll notice that the subscription, resource group, and storage account name are pre-populated. That's to save us some time. So I'll go to Advanced and enable the hierarchical namespace, which then allows us to enable SFTP with just one click. We see the prompt that asks us to create local users to access the SFTP endpoint. Then we can hit review and create the storage account. To save us some time, I'll switch over to a pre-created account. Here you'll see that this account has SFTP and hierarchical namespace enabled. If I go to settings and click SFTP, here I can see my local users and manage them. I'll click add local user, provide a name, and then choose SSH password as the authentication method. In container permissions, I can decide which container this user has access to. And for each of those containers, choose granular permissions. For container one, I'll do read and write. For container two, I will do delete and list. And for container three, I'll provide all permissions. And you can also provide a home directory, which is where the user will land right after the SSH connection is established. And then you can click add. As you see, I already have a pre-created local user, which we'll use for this demo. Now, let's connect to this account through WinSCP, a popular graphical user interface that is used to connect to SFTP servers. I'll click New Session, and you'll see that my hostname and username, as well as password, have already been entered in and are saved. I'll hit Login, and I'm connected to my storage account. You'll see that I have two files in my container one, and I can very easily drag them and download them to my local machine and also upload files from my local machine to the storage account. Now we can go back to the portal, and if we go to containers, navigate to container one, you'll see the file that I just uploaded. And if I double click on it, you'll see the beautiful Seattle skyline. And that's how you can create a storage account and interact with your data with both SFTP as well as the REST API, which is what the portal uses.
So the demo highlighted how you can set up SFTP access to your storage account with just a few simple steps and access SFTP uploaded data via REST or vice versa. The addition of SFTP expands multi-protocol access on Blob Storage, so you can collect data from varied sources in a unified data lake, eliminating data silos. Go to aka.ms/blobsftp to learn more and check out aka.ms connect to Blob with SFTP for a detailed guide on how to set up SFTP for your storage account. You can share questions, feedback, and comments with us at blobsftp@microsoft.com. We are so excited for you to leverage SFTP in your cloud journey. Thank you.